Hi, everybody. So I updated the graphs on Arizona Real Estate Notebook with the latest number from the MLS, so numbers from the MLS for August. And it also includes for the number of homes listed for sale. It's updated through September. So it's a real mixed market. This is the time of year where we get a transition, but it's kind of confusing to me. On the one hand, the median price of homes, and all homes, including condos, went from 215 in June to 208 in August. So that's kind of weird. That was a pretty steep decline. Although we're going into the weaker part of the year, if you would start to see a decline, it would be then. But that's a lot of a decline. But on the other hand, the number of homes that are hitting the market is down. I mean, obviously, if you get a lot of homes starting to hit the market, that suggests prices won't go up as much, or they went up. If you're getting a ton of homes in the market, the price could eventually go down. So we're seeing a lower level of homes hitting the market, suggesting prices wouldn't go down. And we're also seeing sales. Sales are stronger than they were in August compared to the previous August. You can see that when you mouse over on the website. So check that out. So I don't know what's going to happen on the market. On the one hand, we have prices dropping a lot from June to August. On the other hand, we have a tight supply. We're still in a three-month supply. So we'll see what happens. I expect that the inventory of homes, which would be seasonal, would go up steeply between now and, say, November. So we'll see how much it goes up. If it goes up tons, then we're going to come into next year with a strong amount of supply, and prices shouldn't go up that much. But if it's still tight, if we're still at 3 months in November, yikes, prices could go up a lot next year. So we just got to see. I don't know what's happening. One theory that I have is that there was so much talk about an interest rate increase last winter and early spring. They were talking about an interest rate increase from the Fed in June. It didn't happen. Then the talk was that it's going to be an interest rate increase from the Fed in September. And that didn't happen. But it could have pushed a lot of people off the dime. I'm not sure. I can't really quantify it. Of how many people were thinking, oh, there's going to be an interest rate increase, so I need to buy now. And so that may have captured some of those sales earlier that would have happened later. But that's a theory. I don't know what's going to happen. I just got to see what's going to happen to the numbers. Prices, if you go down to the third graph, will show you the inflation adjusted. And prices are a little high on an inflation adjusted basis for my comfort. It's not crazy high. It's not like it's so high we could expect prices to fall. But nevertheless, there's not, in my mind, just looking at that inflation-adjusted graph, there's not a lot of upside potential for home prices. Hey, but what do I know? I didn't predict the prices would go up as much as they did last spring or the first half of this year as they did. So, but that's my best guess for right now. How useful was this video? But if you have any questions, email me. I'd love to hear them. Take care, everybody.